Hello guys, welcome to my video. I'm gonna show you how to link SFML libraries to your CodeBlocks project. So for that you need to install CodeBlocks, obviously. Now considering you already have installed CodeBlocks, then you need to go and download SFML libraries from sfml.org. You can Google it, and then you go to downloads tab, then you download appropriate version for your system. I hope you are that smart. And then you just go to the CodeBlocks. Now there are two ways to link your SFML libraries. First way is to go to the settings and go to the compiler, and then just change the linker settings according to your need. But I'm gonna show you the way I do it. I'm gonna create a project. I'm gonna change the settings in the project build options. That is more reliable and more efficient for me. Not efficient, it's just, you know, it just works after I build it properly. So I'm gonna go to the empty project and create a new project. I'm just gonna name it example for this example. I'm gonna hit next, finish, and I have this project created and it's empty, there's nothing in it. So I'm gonna right click it and go to the build options. In that, I'm gonna click the project itself. I'm gonna go to the linker settings. Now let me zoom it a little bit so you can see it properly. Now I'm gonna add SFML system. I'm gonna add another thing called SFML graphics. Now these are the libraries that are associated with SFML, so you have to add it or perhaps link it. Now SFML network is something there, but we don't need it actually, but I'm just gonna show you for this demonstration purpose. And then SFML window, it's just a window. These are some of the libraries. There is also audio you might want to add, but for demonstration let's just keep this simple. Now go to the search directories in that compiler, in that select compiler, and then go to add. Now add the include directory of SFML that you downloaded. Now you have to extract it, obviously. Now you can use zip of that. Now include. Now you're just gonna add the include directory of the SFML folder. So yes and okay. Now go to the linkers tab and add the lib directory of lib, lib directory of SFML. Yes and okay, hit okay and hit okay again. Now we're gonna zoom back a little bit, yeah. And then go to the build options again, and you have to do the same for debug and release. I'm just gonna go for the debug right now because we're just gonna have a little demonstrations, and then we can just assume that you can do that same for release. It's just, you just gotta add this. I already did that. System. We're gonna go to the search directories. We're gonna add again compiler. We're gonna go find that SFML folder in that include like directory. We're gonna say next. Okay. It's just the same thing I'm doing for the debug. Sorry for the delay. Okay, so now we are already set up. Now we're just gonna hit new and go to the empty file. We're just gonna press yes, and we're gonna name it something. Let me name it main.cbaby. Okay, now what we're gonna do is grab some code off the website SFML and to check whether it's working or not. So we're gonna paste this code, we're gonna press save, control S, and then we're gonna build this, and hopefully this will build. Now when you hit play, it doesn't play. There are some DLL missing. So what can you do about this? So first go to the SFML folder which you downloaded, and in that go to the bin directory and copy all those DLL files and go to the projects folder, that's example. In that go to the bin folder, in debug folder and then paste all these files in this directory. Still it won't run, so we go to the bin directory of the minw. Hope you can see this. Let me zoom in for you. You're gonna go to the this PC, C program files, code blocks, minw bin directory. Actually it's not obvious that this directory is gonna be the same for you, but just go to the code blocks directory and in that minw and that bin directory. Now in this you have to copy these two files, libgcc sjlj and libstdc++. I don't know why we're gonna copy this, but this is how it works. Now we're gonna copy these two files and then we're gonna paste it in the projects debug folder and then we're gonna double click this and it runs. And you can play it from here also, it works. So this is how you can link your SFML libraries within your project. I hope you liked this video and hope this was helpful. See you later in a later video, maybe a new one. Till then, bye.